Okay, we're going to do some texturing today. Using the lightweight topping is the perfect texture for applying that, so we're going to go ahead and start there. You can go down and get at a rental yard any of these hoppers. Get yourself a drill with a whip on it like there. And we're just going to put a little bit of water in the mud. Mix up until we get the right consistency, which would be about a little lighter than cream of wheat. And I'll show you that as we pour it into the sprayer. So go pick up a sprayer and down at the rental yard, and you're ready to start texturing. Pull that up. Okay, we're going to pull it up. No, don't worry about that. You ain't going to do it anymore. Pull it up. You can see the consistency there. That's about the texture you want. You want to have a little bit like that. Maybe we'll add a little bit more water to that. And we want it to drip a little bit faster than that. And that'll be perfect. Just add a little bit more water there. He's going to whip it one more time. Pull it up, let's see it drip. No, that's drip. Okay, that looks good. Alright, that's a good consistency right there. So, we're going to go ahead and set that off to the side, and we're going to put it into our spray rig. Again, these rigs you can pick up at any rental center, and they'll give you a compressor, a hose, and a spray rig. And they have different size holes on them for different kinds of texture, and we're using the small one now. The first one, we're going to use a small one to cover up some of the lines on the wallpaper, and then we're going to use a medium one to do Mediterranean knockdown. So we'll start with that. If you want to just pour it right into your hopper, go ahead. Pour it about 3/4 of the way. So that's your consistency there. Pour it in nicely. You want to maintain the consistency. that way the texture goes on exactly the same from start to finish on your job. So when you go to make a next batch, it should pour out the same way. Okay, go ahead and pour it right in. And again, this is the consistency you're looking for here, folks. It should be pouring right out into your hopper, and that's the same consistency all the way through. It'll give you a, then you can use your ends here. So you have, right now I have the largest one on. Here's your small one, your medium one, the large one, just one size bigger. And it works great for the Mediterranean knockdown, which we have here. It'll look just like this when it's wet. As soon as you see the sheen go away, mm-hmm. then you start knocking it down. Right now it's set up, right now as the sheen's on there, it's nice and wet, looks real consistent throughout. And then as soon as the sheen goes away, starts to go away, then you knock it down and the plateaus stay. Right now, if you were to knock it down now, it'd just be, it's smear mud. You just have one big blob of mud. But by waiting until the sugar, it leaves the mountains there, and you're just knocking down the tops. So it works out fantastic. Okay, so you want to go ahead and set your thing up for about 35 pounds. Hold your gun at about like this, and as you start, give it a... And when you have it like that, you just want to watch the consistency of it, maintain the consistency through the whole thing. Then when you go to knock it down, I'll show you how to knock it down. Turn it off. Okay, so when you're knocking down texture, you want to put it on nice and heavy. And look at the mountains again. As soon as the gloss is gone, then you'll knock it down. Just keep your blade, look at the blade and see if it's rounded anywhere. If it's rounded, put the round side this way, so you don't drag lines, but go like this, just knock it down like that. As you go like this, it'll make the perfect plateaus for knockdown. If you're going to use orange peel, you just simply spray it on whatever size you want and you're done. But if you want knockdown, you'll just put it on, wait for the gloss to go away, and just before the gloss is completely gone, start knocking it down just like this. Okay, and then it'll be perfect. You can't really tell texture. That's why I didn't show you the whole thing, because there's no way for you to really see this. But now you saw how I'm doing it. You spray it, wait for the gloss to go mostly away, take your trowel, and just run it across like that in different directions, and it'll become perfect knockdown. The best light I can get is right here to kind of show you how texture looks, but anyway, it's hard to tell what texture looks like. But anyway, that's the way you do knockdown, okay?